The story is about Susanna Cahalan, who ends up with a disease called anti-NMDA autoimmune encephalitis, and it's treatable. And it had only been discovered a couple of years before that, but nobody really knew about it. And she was lucky enough to be a reporter and to be cured and to write about it. And so it's important because it's going to bring awareness to this this disease. It certainly has, the book certainly brought awareness to the neurological community across the world, so they started looking for it. And, you know, we think sadly of the thousands, probably tens or hundreds of thousands of people who were misdiagnosed and didn't end up getting treated and ended up in a catatonic state or dead or on the street or in a psych ward. And so I think that's why it's important. It's also the story of family sticking together and of perseverance and of, you know, really following your conviction. And the character played by Carrie Ann Moss of Susanna's mother, she was the one who really kept on pushing and said, no, our daughter's in there. And she doesn't have schizophrenia, and you've got to find out what's wrong with her. And eventually they did, which is great.
Susanna's played in this film by one of our glittering young stars in Chloe Grace Moretz. Can you talk a little bit about what makes her such a unique talent and what we can expect from her performance in this specific film?
Well, she is fearless and she just dives in, and it was wonderful working across from her because I never knew what she was going to do next, and so I had to be really on my toes and just rolling with what she was doing. And I think it's one of those parts that we dream of as actors to play a really challenging part like this. And I think she's just done an incredible job. Yeah.
And can you tell us just a little bit about your character, Dr. Ryan, and where he fits into Susanna's journey?
Yeah. Well, Dr. Ryan is one of the first people who sees her in the psych ward and tries to diagnose what's wrong with her, and he can't. And he works very hard to try to figure out what it is. But like literally, maybe five people knew about what this disease was, and so I think in the big scope of things, what he represents is the 99.99% of doctors out there who had no idea what this was. And it's an important sort of force of an obstacle that everybody is pushing against. And you know, he wasn't a bad guy. He wasn't dumb. Nobody really knew about this disease.
I guess, how important do you feel films like this are in destigmatizing mental illness and its treatment?
Yeah, that's a really, really great question, and I really think it's important. You know, we unfortunately as a society like to make fun of people who have mental illness. We tend to walk, you know, the other way when we see them on the street, and we don't do that when people maybe have, you know, a liver disease or, you know, cancer. We tend to give them more care. Somehow there's a stigma with the brain and it scares us more. And I think that hopefully what this will do is allow people to have a little bit more compassion, a little bit more empathy, a little bit more tolerance, so that we can embrace people who are sick, whether the disease is in the mind or whether it's anywhere else in the body.
What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's TIFF?
Oh, it's fantastic. You know, I'm very proud Canadian, and TIFF is such a great festival, and everybody's been so warm, and it's so exciting. Toronto's just buzzing all week, and you get quite exhausted going to the parties and, you know, going to films. We've seen some great films, and it's just great to be here.
And it came to me through Charlize Theron, and she liked my film that I made, Glassland, that premiered at Sundance, and she, you know, liked what I did with that, and I think she liked the simplicity of my work. She liked that, the story structure and to keep in, you know, focused on story, and you know, I jumped at the chance because, you know, it's very rare to get an opportunity to make a film that will save a life, and I think, you know, Susanna's book has saved many lives across the world. People have found it and diagnosed themselves or diagnosed people that they love, and I think with a film, when you visualize something, it can reach an even wider audience. And I think for me, that's the exciting thing, that, you know, hopefully the film will save a life, and that it was well worth making it then. The biggest challenge is that, you know, it's a really big cast. You know, we didn't have a huge amount of time. And, you know, we had to get what we had to get. So, I mean, that's the challenge when it comes down to that. In terms of the material itself, you know, no, not really a challenge. I mean, you know, you go into this with a vision and a confidence that you can work with your actors and get what you want. But I think the challenge was just doing it, you know what I mean? That's the challenge. And then every day I presented a new challenge. You know, there's not a scene in the movie that's not challenging. And so that was the exciting thing.
Hollywood often explores mental health concerns, but often sensationalizes them and explores them in very kind of visual ways. Can you talk about your approach to that and getting that balance right between depicting it in a sincere way but also making it entertaining?
I mean, that was the challenge, you know what I mean? As I said, you could have got caught up in the pitfalls of, you know, being inside her head and inside the brain and all these sort of things. And, you know, I didn't want to go there, you know? I didn't want to reinvent the wheel. I didn't want to reinvent filmmaking about, you know, disease on film. What I wanted to do was tell the story, stand back, become the audience, let the audience live in the world with Susanna, let the audience react of how people reacted around her, and go on from there. And I think that, you know, I have confidence in Chloe. I had confidence in Chloe to do her job, that, you know, I didn't need to use gimmicks, you know?
What was Susanna's first reaction when she saw the movie?
Well, she was on set. I mean, she saw it being made. She saw cuts of it every now and then when I would go and edit it at lunchtime. So, yeah, look, I think, look, it's obviously it's weird for her, and I think it will always be weird for her, and I think, you know, I think it's one of those things where, you know, it must be very odd for her, but I think she's happy with it. I think she's happy that we stuck to the message and that we didn't take advantage of her story, and that was the most important thing, was not to take advantage of her story.
In terms of what you want audiences to take away from this, do you feel that this is a film that can be part, at least, of the ongoing destigmatization of mental health and its treatment?
Look, I want people to take away from this is the disease, what it is, what the symptoms are, and live life to the fullest. That's all I can do. From a political point of view, you know, the only thing that I want to say is that, you know, people in America love giving pills to people, medication over medication. A pill doesn't solve everything, you know. Sometimes you need a doctor that believes in you and that's willing to fight for you. That's all.
First, I met Susanna a few weeks after being admitted to Major Medical Center in Manhattan. At that time, she presented with major psychiatric symptoms. She was overtly psychotic, catatonic, with total loss of all cognitive abilities. She was diagnosed as a form of schizophrenia that is severe and probably about to be placed in mental institution. When I saw her, I realized her brain being attacked by her own immune system. And at that time, I told her parents, her brain is inflamed. In a way, I described it as her brain on fire. Little I know, that became the title of her book and now the title of the movie. I know for a long time that if you have abnormal immune system, can turn against person's brain and can cause psychiatric symptoms. That notion helped me to first of all realize that she has actually not psychiatric illness, but rather psychiatric symptoms of neurological cause. This is an evidence that many psychiatric symptoms are biological in the brain, biological in nature, and have anatomical footprint in the brain. And now it's about the time to close the gap between psychiatry and neurology and to limit the professional isolation that currently exists between those two fields. Her story is a prime example and prototype of a professional isolation we live in between psychiatry and neurology fields.
Unbelievable. It's just been incredible. I feel very grateful tonight. I really do. I think that she just did an amazing job with this. And I'm so grateful for her because she just really gave it her all. And she's so courageous, so strong. It's a strong, powerful woman. And I'm really honored that she's playing me.
Why is this such an important story to tell? And can you talk about your process in being part of a film that very much destigmatizes the treatment and experience of mental health?
Well, you know, I think this movie really talks about the problem with labeling and the problem we have with labeling in our society. You know, they look at a young woman who lives in New York City and they say, oh, you're having a mental breakdown, you do drugs, you're alcoholic, you're this, you're that, when in reality, she was a young girl with a very serious illness that she was predisposed to, and a flu triggered it. And it was as simple as an IV that could bring her back to reality, but she was 2 weeks away from being put into a mental ward, and most likely her end game there would have been death, to perish completely. So, I mean, you know, you're not talking about someone who's just, you know, being put on the wrong mood stabilizers and that's going to ruin them. You're talking about, these are real lives, these are real people. Doctors prescribe things that are incorrect, and people die every day. And this is something that we just need to kind of shed light onto and look past a textbook and look to the person. And to humanize each disease, each illness, and each mental health issue.
Did you have the chance to spend some time with Susanna to be prepared for
the role? Yeah, of course. You know, we would talk all the time, and I wanted to kind of get her mannerisms down. I wanted to understand who Susanna Cahalan was. Our generation in particular is so quick to judge and so quick to label. And I think this movie really sheds light into the fact that we all need to look past a textbook. We all need to see the human behind that, and that, yeah, medicine is medicine. You can go to school for 10 years, and you can learn everything you know about a human being. But what Dr. Suhail did is he sat down with Susanna for the first time after months of doctors seeing her, and he looked into her eyes, and he saw the human. He saw the human trapped within a brain that was distraught with illness. So people need to stop looking at what everything seems like on the surface and actually realize that we do have a lot more going on.